You don't believe in the Torah?
Of course I don't believe in the Torah.
But not this one.
I believe the Torah was given to Moses, but it has changed over time. So what you have at present is not the Torah that I believe was given to Moses. I know there are certain truth in there, like say, when it says to believe in one God, unlike the Christians who believe in the Trinity. I know those things, like Deuteronomy 6:4. Yes? Hear, O Israel.
That's the thing you
can't Shema Israel, Adonai Elohim, Adonai Ahad. I believe that, because that is the Shema, which is very similar to the Shahada. No, not cherry picking.
Yeah, that's
no,
cherry
no, 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 no.
Yeah,
I don't true. Use. I use my Quran as a criteria. I don't cherry pick based on my desires. I use my Quran because the Quran is Al-Muhaymin. Yes, it is the one which oversees what came before, and it distinguishes from the right from the wrong. So there are many things which have changed over time. Yes,
you can't that's prove it.
Well, it's very easy. What is the earliest manuscript you have of the Torah?
It doesn't matter.
It does matter.
It's what you call it in Arabic, tawatur.
But tawatur.
Generation to generation.
No, no, no. Tawatur means it's been agreed upon.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean generation to generation. We have something which is tawatur, which is the Quran. In fact, we have the manuscript, we have the oral tradition alive to this day. Do you have either of them? Between Moses and the earliest extant manuscript. Yeah, between Moses and the earliest extant manuscript of the Torah, there is a 1,000-year gap.
Speaking about that scripture.
Yes, 1,000-year gap.
Okay, what's the oldest scripture of the Quran you have?
Of the Quran?
Yeah.
We are from the time of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's in the Birmingham University.
Okay, let's say the Birmingham University.
From his own.
Yeah.
God caught on fire. Will you still believe in Islam?
Of course.
Even though there is no old scriptures of
no,
Torah.
We have the other scriptures.
Same thing with me.
No, wait. I didn't say for us it is just a manuscript. I said there is two modes. We have the oral tradition, which is the way we memorize the entire Quran from cover to cover. And we got children
same
as young.
Same thing with Torah.
Do you know any is a rabbi who's memorizes from cover to cover, the Torah?
Memorize it by heart?
Yes.
No.
Exactly.
That's the point.
But you know, we have children 6 years old.
12 million
children, and they are not scholars. These children, their language, listen, their language is not even Arabic. But they're able to memorize it.
12 million on earth, but majority not Arabs.
Who would memorize 2,000 pages?
That's not my problem. That's not my problem.
That's
not possible.
Look. If, listen, your book, the first five books,
you
listen,
can memorize the Quran because it's this big.
No, it's not this big. The Arabs, even before the Quran was revealed, they used to memorize poetries, lots of poetries, and they used to memorize it. Even the people in the desert, when they are just shepherds, you know, one of the strong points they had is that they used to memorize. But today, it's not just the Arabs. Today, majority of the Muslim world are non-Arabs. And they memorize, even though the first language is not Arabic. You know why? Because Allah says in the Quran, it's easy to remember. He made it easy to remember. The Torah, in the Torah, you'll never find a verse, or even the New Testament, you'll never find anywhere where God says, I will preserve this book until the end time. There's no guarantee of preservation. But the Quran has a preservation guarantee.